It's intentional. I'm not sitting there saying someone's called Kendrick Lamar into a room and said, hey, Kendrick, I need you to do this song. They not like us, blah, blah, blah. But trust me, none of this stuff is by accident. You put idiots, desperate idiots, who have no fathers in their lives, who were brought up in very nihilistic neighborhoods with nihilistic mentalities, and you decide, hey, we're gonna promote a form of music that you don't need to have achieved anything in school, you don't need to have any values, it's even preferable that you spend some time in jail, you spend some time in a gang, you spend some time in a culture that immerses you in a gang mentality. We have a multi-million dollar contract for you to do nursery school rhymes over beats. We're gonna promote it. We're gonna make this the number one selling form of music. We're going to use you to spread nihilism. You don't tell Kendrick Lamar what he's being used for. He's a useful idiot who's been handed millions of dollars and fame, and he gets to run around and pleasure his penis and spend his money however he wants. He gets the year they gave this dude the Pulitzer Prize, and look it up, it was about a decade ago, they gave this guy the Pulitzer Prize, a dude that curses and does nursery school rhymes. They gave him a Pulitzer Prize for music. I was like, oh my God, what do they have planned for him? And here we are, here we are. Kendrick, someone look it up, I'll look it up as well. Let me be precise about the year Kendrick Lamar won the Pulitzer Prize for music. I want to be, because this is how long this has been.
So yeah, I hear Jason Whitlock speaking about Not Like Us from an American perspective, the impact that it can have on society. He mentioned the Pulitzer Prize winner, Kendrick Lamar. He got the Pulitzer Prize for Good Kid, Mad City, or Damn, or one of those albums. Y'all let me know in the chat. Barack Obama also said that he'd pick Kendrick Lamar over Drake. And notice that when Barack Obama did his top songs of the year, Not Like Us was not on there. I still find that very suspicious. Then when we see that song at the DNC, well, Barack Obama, what happened? You said Kendrick Lamar is your favorite rapper. You put him over Drake, and you don't have the biggest song of his career on your list? Maybe Obama will speak on that later on in the year. Jason called Kendrick Lamar a useful idiot. In the respect of Not Like Us, I don't know if Kendrick Lamar at the beginning of the year was like, yo, I'm about to have the biggest song of my whole career off this and Drake. I don't know. We don't know how deep this goes. But we know that from the first person shooter verse last year, the song First Person Shooter with Drake and J. Cole began the rumblings of Kendrick Lamar not really feeling what's going on. But then you also gotta ask, how does Rick Ross, Future, Metro Boomin, everybody else that they're attached to, how did all Childish Gambino, we know about Drake and Ye West, but how did all of these gentlemen become wrapped up in a situation because Kendrick Lamar did not like First Person Shooter? Even though allegedly there's reports that they asked for Kendrick Lamar to be on the song. When you start throwing in all of the other factors in there, it makes you wonder, how did Drake get walked into a 20v1? And at the beginning of the year, did Kendrick Lamar think that he was gonna have the biggest record of his career? How did Kendrick Lamar get walked into this? This summer was the Drake and Kendrick summer. Since March of this year, everything has been about Drake and Kendrick Lamar. Is Kendrick being used though? Because when you look at Kendrick's history as an artist, how he moves, Not Like Us is a break in tradition with Kendrick Lamar. Unless Kendrick Lamar been talking in code the whole entire time, that song, Not Like Us, it has a radical social vibe with it. And Jason was calling that nihilism. But I mean, when we look at that song, you gotta wonder, these guys managed to unify against Drake Good job. You managed to unify against the Canadian light-skinned, half-black, half-Jewish kid from Canada. When it comes to some of the matters and the social problems going on here, you guys can't fix that. You could unite against Drake some of the more serious problems in not only America, Black America, whatever, the some of the problems in American society. You guys can't unify with that? You guys literally can only unify against the Canadian light-skinned kid? And on top of that, y'all made money with him. Drake gave some of these guys their biggest features. You guys literally all made millions, hundreds of thousands of dollars with Drake. I find this very interesting. Well, yeah, well, what is this being used for? Kendrick Lamar couldn't unite everybody against the regular issues plaguing Black America every day? Look, I'm not trying to get too social here, but I'm really just asking. The Pulitzer Prize winner could have only radicalized the hip-hop world against the Canadian light-skinned Drake. Drake is the only time when people can unify and come on one common ground. I don't know if y'all see how problematic that is, and we might need to do a priority check. I find that interesting, okay? Y'all make sure y'all check out Jason Whitlock. Shout out to Jason Whitlock and everybody over there. And make sure y'all like, share, comment, and subscribe. If y'all enjoying the vibe, y'all pull back up and thrive with us, all right? And make sure you vibe with us. Get alive with us. Say rah with us. Have a great day, everybody.